Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13.6 has been out for a few days, and I've been using it on the iPhone 11, and I've also done a YouTube community poll where thousands of you have voted, and many hundreds of you, over 600, have commented. So I took all of that information to give you an idea if you should update to iOS 13.6, or maybe just hang on and use iOS 14 Beta 2. So we're going to talk about both. iOS 14 Beta 2 has been out for a couple weeks at this point, so we should see an update soon. I'll talk more about that in a little bit. Now, the first thing I wanted to share is a little bit of new news, and that is new emoji that Apple has shared with the Unicode Consortium. And basically, these are emoji that will be coming later this year. And so you can see there's a couple new symbols, such as boba. You've got lungs and a heart and a couple other things as well. There will be more than this, but there's all sorts of different things that will be included with that update. And I know a lot of people like emoji. That's just to keep up with the Unicode Consortium. So Apple updates theirs with their own style of emoji, but also Android will be updating theirs as well as Microsoft as well. It's just sort of a standard that's set and they update it. So Apple keeps up with whatever that standard is that's released every couple months or so as to what will be next. Now, as far as iOS 13.6, people are saying, I saw in some of the comments that I don't have the update yet. Are you sure it's out? And yes, it's out for everyone at the exact same time around the entire world. So if you don't have it, just go to settings, then go to general, go to software update, and make sure that you have automatic updates turned off when you're checking. Otherwise, it may not show up, but you should have it. Once you've installed it, a few people were saying that the phone was getting abnormally warm or it was getting really hot on the back. And the first day or so, it will be a little bit warm, at least for the first few hours. And that's because it's processing in the background. So I saw a few people talk about that. It does seem to be getting warm. And then after a day or so, it goes back to normal for most people. And so when you're charging it, it will get warm. If you're doing intensive tasks, maybe recording 4K video, it will get warm. That's just normal. And that's the CPU inside warming up as it's working harder to do that. Now, as far as other things people are saying and what I've experienced is performance is quite good. Scrolling is quite good. It may hiccup a second while it's loading, but in general, performance is good. You don't really have any hiccups scrolling, no lockups, no freezing. And in general, it's been really good. And the other good thing is most people are saying mail is working properly now. So I know some people were having issues with mail, maybe it not showing the new messages. You'll see I have 5 here. You'd go in and then it would refresh. People are saying mail is working great now. But there are a few issues people are having with it. Battery is not one of them. I'll talk about that in a moment. But there are a couple people saying that other than the phone getting warm, someone said that the sound is different from the speakers. I didn't notice any difference, but I did notice someone saying that, so I thought I'd bring it up. And another person was saying their camera is blurry. Now, if your camera's blurry, that may be a problem with the physical lenses themselves. Maybe they got bumped or something. So try a hard reset, just doing the, depending on what phone you're using, do a hard reset, force restart the phone, and it usually will take care of that. But if I just snap a picture here, it looks fine. It doesn't look blurry to me. You'll see if I zoom in there, it looks pretty good. So I'm not seeing this blur issue. Other people may see it, but I haven't. However, I have had multiple people report that the share menu is not working. So maybe you want to share a website. If we go into Safari, this is Apple's support page. Maybe we want to share it. They say that their share menu is not working. It seems to work fine for me. I know some people were saying that it's blank. I saw some screenshots. If that's doing that, reboot the phone and see if it fixes it. I haven't seen it on any of my devices, but I did see a couple people reporting that. Now, as far as battery life is concerned, well, this phone is not my main phone, so I didn't use it, but I did use the poll to determine how many people had this issue. So over 115 comments were left regarding battery. And so I took all of those, compiled them into good and bad, whether or not you should update. But if we take a look at my battery health, this one should be at 100%. My other phone, I think, is at 97% on iOS 14. And keep in mind, your battery health is not affected by updates. It's just simply rechecking the hardware, seeing where the battery is at. So this one's at 97% on my 11 Pro Max. So 80% after 2 years is completely normal, according to Apple. I honestly would just ignore it. I don't check it normally other than for these videos. So just ignore it. I wouldn't worry about it. And if it tells you you need to replace it, then replace it. Now, as far as battery life, 74% of you are saying that it is the same or better battery life than iOS 13.5.1. It does not seem to be specific to device. It just seems to be all devices are getting better battery life. Only 26% of you are saying that it is worse battery. So that's a pretty good sign. Now, keep in mind, I took all of this information from the comments in the YouTube community poll. There was over 600 comments, and we'll look at some of those in a minute. But those comments, I took them, read them all as far as the battery comments, and if they were specific to 13.6, I calculated that out. So 74% better, 26% worse. So I would say most people, it's pretty safe to update. Those numbers were lower with 13.5.1. Now, as far as iOS 14 beta 2, well, it's been out a couple weeks. It's been really steady for an early beta. So it's been super stable. And for an early beta, that's saying something. Usually the first two or three betas are very unstable. You'll have crashes all over the place. Now, I have had a few issues with touch inputs, sometimes just scrolling, and some things are weird, but performance in general is pretty good on this. And I've had a good experience with iOS 14 in general. The same is true with iPadOS. Not really any issues on the iPad. My battery life seems to be pretty solid, and you'll see over the last 10 days, if we take a look at yesterday, it wasn't great. So battery life is not a priority early on with new updates. This is meant to be tested. It's not meant for main devices usually. So just keep that in mind. You'll see I got only about 5.5 hours of screen on time, 7.5 hours of screen off time. So I'd say that's pretty okay. 10 to 12 hours of screen on time is normal for this phone. So it's not doing amazing or anything, but it's an early beta. So I'm not really concerned about that with iOS 14. It will improve as the beta gets closer to a final release. Now, as far as updates are concerned, expect iOS 14 beta 3 probably Tuesday at this point. It could be earlier, it could be later, but generally every 2 weeks, at least in the first three betas or so, and then they switch to a weekly basis or weekly update basis where they come out every week. So maybe beta 3 and beta 4 will be on a 2 week basis, but expect it Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday at the latest, based on what they've done before. You never know with Apple, they could change it, but hopefully we'll see it earlier rather than later. Now, as far as iOS 13, Apple does continue to work on it. So we may see a 13.6.1 to address a few bugs, and they will address security concerns for years to come with iOS 13 supported devices. So keep in mind, they'll probably keep supporting this. Although once iOS 14 comes out, there's no need for them to update 13 since it supports all the same devices. So 13.6.1 may be something we'll see. It's hard to say, but I'm not sure at this point. Now, before we take a look at the YouTube community poll, here are all of the other issues mentioned. So 115 people mentioned battery at the time of making this video. That may have been mentioned multiple times by different people. So just keep that in mind, and that's good and bad. Also, here are all of the devices you're using. It seems like a lot of you are using iPhone 11s at this point, more than any other phone in these polls. So it's great to get an idea of what you're using, and a lot of people using iPads as well. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now you'll see I ran this poll, at least at the time of this recording, about 24 hours ago or more, and you'll see 9.3K people voted, or 9,300 people. So I really appreciate that. And comments wise, there's 655 at the time of making this video. So that's phenomenal. I really appreciate everyone commenting. And you'll see 47% of you said iOS 13.6 is great. Only 2% of you are saying it's terrible. 7% of you are saying okay, but some bugs. So only 9% of you are seeing any issues whatsoever with this particular version. 29% of you are using a different version, whether that be iOS 14 or iOS 13.5.1 or older, and 16% of you are using Android. And again, thank you for voting, even if this isn't relevant to you. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. It's been good so far. Haven't had any issues on the iPhone SE first generation. My phone was getting warm for the first 2 days, but it seems to have calmed down. iPhone 7 Plus, strange experience since installing 20 hours ago. To start, I got 3+ hours of screen on time from the battery, only using 27%. Now it's dropping like a stone. Otherwise, no bugs. 13.6 running stable on 6S. Apps seem to reload more often, but might be my impression. Battery life is the same. It finally stopped the continuous background activity on several apps that were draining the battery on my 8 Plus. SE 2020, no known issues, runs as it should. Thanks, and thank you for commenting. I am on XS Max, and on 13.6, I have experienced some freezes on almost every other app when I revisited them, apps like Messenger, Facebook, Instagram, etc. The problem was resolved after updating all of the apps. I am unsure about the battery being better than 13.5. Battery life on iOS 13.6 for iPhone 7 is significantly improved. Best version for battery out of all the iOS 13 versions. Performance is very fast as well. Smooth app openings, etc. Overall, the best update to date. The phone gets warmer. I think there is some app or bundle of apps that are causing loads of energy consuming. I haven't been able to locate which they are. Normally, I recommend if it doesn't stop to do a hard reboot, and that usually resets it and it goes back to normal. Very great. Battery seems great too so far. I'm using iPhone XS Max. Been great on my iPhone 11. No issues. iOS 13.6 update. Recently, no issues whatsoever. Currently, I am using iPhone SE 2020. It's awesome. I'm using my iPhone XR on iOS 14. I had 13.6 for a couple of weeks. I'm assuming you mean the beta. And battery life was amazing. iOS 14 is amazing, but battery took a toll as expected. I use iOS 14 on my iPhone and iPadOS 13 on iPad, and I think I didn't notice anything bad or wrong about the latest update. Hopefully this update must be under the hood fixes and improvements. Nice and smooth, running it on my XS Max, good battery life, fixed issues sometimes the app would close automatically, especially the text messages app, right when I clicked on it would just close. iPhone XS with iOS 13.6, obviously. I haven't noticed anything amiss, and Apple Mail seems much better behaved for me, at least thus far. New mail counts are accurate, and mail is present when I look. No complaints here. Battery drain issue, same as 13.5.1. Usually leaving it there untouched will not drain battery. Wi-Fi, Bluetooth data off before it can last me a week, plus with my iPhone idle, but now 3 to 4 days. Now, if you're having the same issue, there's got to be an app using something in the background. Usually, or at least according to most people here, the battery is better. So you've got to have something running that's causing that drain. Using iOS 13.6 on iPhone 10 and iPadOS on iPad 6th gen, battery drain RAM management bug seems to have been fixed. Not having apps stay active off screen for hours on end. Thanks for the content. You're welcome. Thanks for viewing. Using an iPhone 6S Plus, no issues at all. A little sluggish right after the update. Today, very good, no issues, peppy and responsive. Battery jury is still out, probably about the same, time will tell. After updating, I thought that the battery drain bug from 13.5.1 has been fixed, but iOS 13 still have this bug. Overnight, iPhone 6S would be drained, left at 90% battery, and woke up empty for 10 hours of sleep. There's definitely something going on in the background, and there's a lot of things that go on when you put when you go to sleep and the phone is kind of in a sleep mode. If you're on Wi-Fi, it's doing backups and things. I recommend just leaving it plugged in. It will manage the battery, and I've plugged in every phone overnight since the original iPhone and never had an issue. No major problems to speak of. No crashes on my iPhone XR. Battery health is at 95%, which is a little concerning. Looking forward to the final version of iOS 14 and iPhone 12. iOS 13.6 running okay on iPhone 7. Battery life is really bad and phone gets hot very quickly. Hoping iOS 14 will fix this. And someone replied and said, I had battery life issues on 11 iOS 13.5.1, but now on 13.6, it's good again. Not great. Maybe you should replace your battery. You're probably just having processing going on in the background. Give it a day or so, leave it plugged in, and it should be okay. And then other people are saying terrible battery life, but most people are saying it's better, like I said. So it just depends on what phone you're using and how long it's been since you installed the update. So that's it for iOS 13.6, as well as iOS 14 Beta 2. Expect iOS 14 Beta 3 in the next couple of days or so if Apple continues to do what they've done in the past. And with 13.6, well, we'll probably see an additional small update to 13.6.1 or something like that. So let me know what you're looking most forward to in the fall here, when we'll have iPhone 12, as well as iOS 14, macOS Big Sur, watchOS 7, and all of the other updates as well. If you'd like to get your hands on these wallpapers, I'll link them in the description. I couldn't decide which one I liked more. So the iOS 14 wallpaper on the left or the iOS 13.6 wallpaper, I'll link both of them in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.